Aki Kareem for British Boxers, and we're here at Matthew Hatton's new facility, and a kind of a new signing in a way as well with Damian Chambers. And before we get on to sort of talk, we're going to talk to you, Matthew, about the facility in a bit. But firstly, it'd be great to have a little chat about your new cruiserweight prospect, Damian. So can you just tell us firstly how you sort of ended up working together?
Yeah, well, I was friends with Damien's amateur coach, Steve Strong, and he used to bring Damien sparring to my gym with a few of the other guys, a few pros I was training. And that's when I first saw Damien, and I was really impressed, strong guy. He was coming every now and again, really, doing some training at the gym. And then I'd say probably 4 months ago, we were just messaging each other on chatting about different things on Facebook. And I just said to him, had he ever thought about turning professional? And he said, yeah, I have thought about it and regret not doing it. And I just said to him, you know, better late than never. Damien's 28, but he really looks after himself. He's a great athlete. So, you know, he's everything's gone through with the British Boxing Board of control now. And we're good to go for October the 7th, and I'm really excited about this, man.
Brilliant, brilliant. And Damien, obviously when you're looking for a professional coach, you know, you can't get really better than someone that's been there and campaigned at some of the very highest levels, can you?
So exactly, yeah.
when you knew it was finalised, you were working with Matthew, what was your sort of initial thoughts?
Yeah, I was buzzing, like, you know, because being from Preston and that, there's not much of a variety of coaches and pro coaches and stuff. Moving down here, I didn't really know like many pro coaches at all. I thought I was just going to stay amateur, you know, and then I started training at Matt's gym. And it was in the back of my mind, you know, like thinking turning over, but deep down I was thinking, you know, I'm 28 and I've not had many fights, you know, I've still got a long way to go. And then he said, you know, as long as you look after yourself, you know, you should do all right, you know. But I eat good, I train well, you know, so it's never too late.
And they do say that the heavier the weights you go up, the longer your career could last, don't they?
Yeah, yeah.
And what's Damian like in training then? I've just seen some snippets there. Obviously trains hard.
Trains very hard. Damian's very, very fit. And like I say, sometimes it's not necessarily the age, it can be the miles on the clock. Damien's had, you know, 8 fights, so he's still fresh. He really looks after himself and he's phenomenally fit. Some of the training he does, in fact, he never stops training. Sometimes I've got to tell him to chill out a little bit, but fitness will be a strength for Damien. So even though he's 28, I've got no, that's not going to hold him back. He's got a long, long time in the sport if he wants it. And, you know, he's got a very eye-catching style. You know, he can box, but the biggest thing about Damien is his phenomenal punch power. He can really, really punch.
Right, yeah, and of course you had 8 amateur fights, didn't you? Which isn't an extensive career, obviously, but you won all 8 of them. And then made the decision to turn over. I mean, I've already noticed as well, you've got quite a good following already. So, you know, where have you developed this good following from?
Most of them from when I lived in Preston. I used to do bits of rapping and stuff as well, a few shows. I don't know, basically Preston's not massive, is it? So everyone knew everyone.
Yeah.
So most of my following's from down there, but from up there, should I say. A lot around. I lived around Glossop for a bit and then lived in Manchester for the past couple of years. So. Just groups of people from everywhere, really. My brother, he's done a bit of boxing, so he was quite known. So he's got a following in like Liverpool ways and stuff like that. So I've got family in Liverpool, so quite scattered about, really.
Yeah, brilliant. Now, if I asked you to do some rapping one day on a video, would you be up for that?
Maybe.
All right. I'll take that as a yes. All right. Go on, Matthew, what were you going to say?
I can just picture it there, coming out to one of these fights, rapping away with me in the background. Could be a new look for me, that, mate.
Yeah. I can imagine, Matthew Hatton, the new Adrian Broner of boxing.
Yeah.
And of course, as well, you know, you guys are coming into the cruiserweight division, which is in recent times in domestically become a really good division.
It's exciting at the moment.
Loads of local talent and prospects in that division, so I suppose that must excite you both. To get into that, you know, to be coming into an exciting division.
Yeah, like you say, there's some good fighters in Manchester now, in and around the division, and there is that excitement about the big guys. And as you can see, you know, Damien's a big unit, and like you say, he's got a very exciting style to watch. You know, we're working on his defence, working on little technical aspects of his game, but he's going to be a roller coaster with this man, it really is. And I'm excited to be a part of it. I'm really looking forward to the 7th of October and getting him moving, getting him pushed on.
Yeah. And Damian, you're obviously in good nick. I mean, you frame for a cruiserweight is pretty much ideal. And back in the day, cruiserweights was sometimes could look like blowing up light heavyweights, you know, that sort of thing. But you're in pristine condition, so you know, has that been something you've always had? Have you always been into sports and that?
Yeah, always. I mean, I boxed on and off for years, and then when I wasn't boxing, I was lifting weights, you know. But people say, do you not reckon you could turn into a heavy, like potentially be a heavyweight, like? And I don't know, you know, with the amount of training you do and stuff, like weight just drops off you. I wouldn't mind in the future at some point, you know, but we'll see how cruiserweight goes.
Damien, like you said, Aki, you know, just got to look at him. He's got the perfect build for a cruiserweight. If you got Damien on the scales now, he'd probably be 14.4, 14.7 tops. This is what he weighs, so it's the perfect weight division for him.
Yeah, absolutely. And of course, as well, the 7th of October, that's the big date for you, for your pro debut now. It was meant to be the week before, and now it does clash with the Anthony Crawler and Ricky Burns bill, which is a bit of a shame, obviously, but still, great venue, bowlers, local Manchester show, so, you know, it's all guns for you guys for that show, isn't it?
Yeah, can't wait, yeah.
Like you say, it's an excellent bill as well, you know, I think there's about 10 fights on the bill, four title fights. It's a shame that it clashes with a Crawler, but it is what it is. Damien, like I say, he's got a good following, he'll have all the people that matter to him behind him, 10 fight bill, four title fights, it's going to be a great night.
Yeah, and it is a great build. I mean, Damien, there's lots of young talent. Is Matty Main on that one as well?
Matty should have been on it. No, Matty's taking a bit of time out at the minute. Okay. Yeah.
There's a lot of local talent on there. I know Jordan Thompson's on there as well, isn't he? You know, there's other people there on that bill. It's good to be on a bill with loads of these young prospects, isn't it? So it's almost like you're coming up together in a way, isn't it?
But yeah, like you say, we was meant to fight on the end of this month. But a few people that was meant to be coming there can't make it now, but still got quite a few people coming, you know. Should be exciting, I can't wait. It's not changed anything for me, just, you know, just an extra week of training, that's all I see it.
All right.
So I'm ready to go.
Well, it's been great, you know, coming down here and just sort of catching up with you and finding out a little bit more about you and all that sort of stuff. Any sponsors you want to shout out or anything like that?
Platform Performance.
Oh yeah.
And obviously Matt's gym. But yeah, this fight, I've not really been reaching out for sponsors, you know. I just want to get this one out of the way, and then after that, we'll start hitting some sponsors up and that, yeah.
Brilliant. All right, well, we're really looking forward to seeing you out there, and, you know, looking forward to following your progression as you go along. And
all right, thanks.
I wish you guys the absolute best. Damien, Matt, thanks for your time.
Nice one, mate. Cheers.